mentioned here in the introduction, today we celebrate Samvidhan Divas, Constitution Day. Now, Indian Constitution is the largest in the world. A lot of thought, consultation with experts in different fields had all gone into the shaping of the Constitution. It was a whole democratic process that gave rise to the Constitution in the first place. And it is the Constitution that ensures that democracy reigns in India. Today, we celebrate Constitution Day. Now, this observation as a day began only a few years ago. Earlier, it was a legal day. Now today, again, when we fear that the values and the sanctity of the Constitution might be challenged, it is in danger, let us reaffirm the values that are put forward by the Constitution. I will recite the preamble of the Constitution. We will convert that into a pledge if you will repeat it after me. Shall we do that?
Yes.
Yes. So this is the preamble shaped by great minds with the benefit of the country in view, with the people at the uppermost of their minds. We, the people of India, have solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic, and to secure to all its citizens, justice, social, economic, and political, liberty, of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality, of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all, fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual, and the unity and the integrity of the nation, in our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November,
1949.
We reaffirm it today. To hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. So if you notice, we the people of India give this Constitution to ourselves. We are the guardians of this Constitution, and let us try to abide by this. I would also like to remember all the shapers of this Constitution headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. I would also like to point out the presence of four women from Kerala who were also part of this. Annie Muscreen, Dakshayani Velayuthan, and Ammu Swaminathan, three of them, right. And I also remember the feeling that I had when I saw the original Constitution written in calligraphy, handwritten Constitution, a huge book which is kept in the library of the Parliament. The sacredness of the whole text, the involvement of the people who shaped it, came back to one's mind. So I urge you to take some time to look into what the Constitution stands for today. Now, this observation does not end in one day. It will be a year-long process which will provide you opportunities to look into what this great Constitution of ours stands for.